this training is our annual one-week training. It's part of a larger climate change training program that we have, where we offer this and we also offer one-day courses on climate change by sector. We can walk away and more people know about climate change and how it affects development programming. More people know how to do climate risk management, are excited about that and excited to champion this sort of work in their missions, and that to me would be a success.
I think that this training provided all the participants with a better understanding of the interactions of climate and development, and it gave us an opportunity to learn from other participants and an opportunity to understand how the climate change adaptation and vulnerability would fit in different parts of the project life cycle.
I'll be able to talk with cities in a clearer fashion about what are their risks based on thinking about exposure, thinking about the sensitivities, and how they need to develop adaptive capacity.
I've been learning a lot about all the climate politics around climate change, all the topics related to sustainable landscape, adaptation, which are topics fairly new for me. I work most of the time in clean energy, so getting all that information and trying to find the links and the relationship between clean energy, mitigation, adaptation.
Right now in Uganda, we are finalizing preparation of our CDCS 2.0, and I'm taking lead in as a facilitator in doing climate risk screening for the strategy. And so when I get back to the mission, I'll use the knowledge I've learned to accomplish that task.
I usually work with the technical team. I will understand more about the work they perform.
I believe it's important that everybody who works on USAID programs understands the risk that we have in terms of climate change and actually understands how to integrate it into our programming so that we can be able to have effective development assistance.
When you really look at the implications of the climate change issues, you know, it's going to affect everything, and it's really not an environmental issue, it's the development issue, and you know, it affects everything we do and everything that these countries need to be thinking about. So in that sense, I think it's, you know, kind of the challenge of our time. You know?